The following report contains some disturbing images.
An old blanket to cover a corpse. There's no dignity in death in Syria. What happened here almost defies words. The end of the school day, a playground full of teenagers, and an incendiary bomb that killed over 10 pupils and left many more writhing in agony. We met the man who took this video, we saw the victims, and we visited the scene. The headmaster doesn't want to be identified, but he explained what happened.
This was the most horrific thing. We've seen images on TV, we've heard many stories, but we've never seen anything like this before. The worst thing in life is watching someone die right in front of you, and you can't do anything. There were dead people, people burning and people running away. But where to? Where would they go? It's not safe anywhere. That's the fate of the Syrian people.
Eyewitnesses described seeing a fighter jet flying repeatedly overhead. Apparently, he was looking for targets. Throughout this conflict, gatherings of people outside have consistently been bombed. Outside bakeries, markets, hospitals, and schools. The air is still thick with the smell of whatever liquid, whatever chemical it was, that was dropped here. And it's hard to imagine and hard to describe the horrors of what the pilot did that day.
They arrived like the walking dead. We don't know for sure what was in the bomb, but the injuries and debris suggests something like napalm or thermite. There were no shrapnel injuries and little blood, just appalling burns. Among the medics here was a British doctor visiting for the charity Hand in Hand.
I need a pause because it's just absolute chaos and carnage here. We've had a massive influx of what looked like serious burns. It seems like it must be some sort of, I'm not really sure, maybe napalm, something similar to that. But obviously, within the chaos of the situation, it's very difficult to know exactly what's going on.
This wasn't a chemical weapon, but a so-called conventional one. Banned from being used in civilian areas by many countries. But 15-year-old Ahmed's government hasn't signed that treaty.
Dear United Nations, you're recalling peace. You're calling for peace. What kind of peace are you calling for? Don't you see this? Don't you see this? What do you need to see? We are just human beings. We want to live, you know? Isn't it our right to live? Isn't it?
In a basic hospital funded by handouts, the emergency beds were full. Patients slumped to the floor, pleading for help. Gasping for water. By sundown, the chaos eased a little, and a brief moment for the British doctor to collect her thoughts.
We feel like some sort of, not even a second-class citizen, we just don't matter. Like all of these children and all of these people who are being killed and massacred, we don't matter. The whole world has failed our nation. And it's innocent civilians who are paying the price.
Most of the victims had more than 50% burns, which means their chances of survival is less than half. Arguments about chemical weapons don't matter here. What does is just death itself. Ian Pannell, BBC News, in northern Syria.